morning?
Yes.
This is the dough, manta dough.
Okay.
For three and a half large trays of manta.
Well, it's...
And... And this is my version out of the AGBU cookbook.
Okay, I can't see it.
What are you going to see?
I just want to see on here what it says.
These are the amounts that I use for the way I make manta.
Okay.
The AGBU cookbook is different.
Okay.
Because we are always too many, and I like to make like three and a half,
okay.
Three or three and a half large trays.
Mm-hmm.
So we can all have, you know, kind of one large tray will serve like four people generously,
mm-hmm.
You know, because everybody wants a second helping.
Okay.
So you copy this amount.
Okay.
Can you see what's on here?
No, I'll write. I can't,
you're
but I'll write it later, yeah.
You're going to write it and video it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, then I don't have to hold it anymore?
No.
Okay.
No, sorry I made you do that.
Now,
so what have you done? What?
To start with your ingredients are onions, ground beef, either round steak or top sirloin, or you can mix it with ground lamb. When lamb is cheaper, I usually mix lamb with it, half and half.
Okay.
Because lamb is very expensive, and it makes it tastier.
Yeah.
So you use the ground beef, the onion, salt and pepper, the yogurt to, after it's baked, when you're serving it, and sumac.
Mm-hmm.
If you want, you can make a pressed garlic in the yogurt and mix it around and tap it on the mantas.
Oh, that sounds good.
Yeah, that's how we serve it, with chicken broth, hot chicken broth.
Uh-huh.
Now, some people add the chicken broth to the cooked manta in the tray, pop it in the oven for 5 minutes, so the mantas get soft. But we don't like it served soft.
No.
We like to dish out the mantas in the bowls. Then at the table, we add as much chicken broth as we want. And that way, the mantas stay crunchy if you like them crunchy. But if you don't like them crunchy, you just put it in the oven and for 5 minutes before you serve it. And then, you know, put the chicken broth in the tray with the manta, warm it up about 5-10 minutes, and then you can serve it that way.
Okay.
But the mantas will be soft. Okay. That's it then.
Okay. That's so what have you done now? You started doing...
That's the way you do it.
Okay.
Now, I have the special amounts of ground beef and lamb, half and half, for our... for making it like three and a half large trays of manta. I have it already. The meat is already.
Okay.
Now, we chop about three onions into the pan and with a little olive oil, very little olive oil. Saute the onions a little bit until they get soft around and not cooked, just soft. Then add the meat to it and start browning the meat.
Oh, and you've done that here, I can see.
I have made this one batch. This is one batch. This is how it looks.
Mm-hmm.
You saute them together, season it, but be careful you don't dry the meat. Don't saute it too much. Just so they're held together, you know.
Mm-hmm.
This is the way it should look.
Okay. Perfect.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Now,
so that's the first step, is making your meat.
That's the first step of making your meat. If you want, you can add a little butter when you're putting the onions with the olive oil. Put a touch of butter to saute the onions.
Okay.
After they're sauteed, then you add the meat.
Okay.
And when the meat is ready, not cooked hard, it has to be not browned. because they're going to cook again in the oven, in the mantas.
Just partially cooked.
Partially, yes. Okay. Soft. They have to be soft. So, now the cookbook tells you you make it with raw meat.
Uh-huh.
It doesn't tell you to brown the meat.
Oh.
In the cookbook.
Okay.
It doesn't tell you to brown the meat. The HEB cookbook is with raw meat.
Okay.
Now, my sister Christine makes it with raw meat, but we don't like it that way.
Right.
It doesn't taste the same.
No. It doesn't have that flavor.
No. It doesn't taste. But they like it. It's easier to make because it holds together real good, you know.
Ah.
Real good.
Now, do you make the meat the night before?
I make the meat the day before and refrigerate it because it's easier to handle. Pinch by pinch, you have to put it in the squares. So it's easier to handle. They stick together better.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be cold, and not warm.
Okay. And then you make enough for three trays. And
three and a half trays with the amount of dough. I'm going to give you the amounts.
And then how many people does that usually serve?
Oh, we're about, what, 8 people.
So like 8 or 9?
Yeah, yeah.
With second helping.
And I serve a salad before. And everybody likes to eat manta if you make enough. You don't need to have anything else.
Okay.
But if you want to have chicken, you know,
mm-hmm.
cooked chicken, you can serve it, a little piece of chicken, too.
Okay, I'm going to fade out for a second, and then take a break.
Auntie Nan's coming over.
Who?
Auntie Nan.
It tells you to chop the onions fine.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to chop the onions now.
Don't you start crying? I can't stand chopping onions.
Crying? Oh, you know the secret about chopping onions?
No.
After you peel the outer layers, have a bowl of cold water over there and drop the onion in there.
Oh, okay.
And wet your knife with the cold water in your hands. Then you will not cry.
Oh, that's a good
and
secret.
Also, it's nice to have an open window by you when you're chopping an onion. But this is the best way. Mm. Okay, here we go now. Fine. You don't want them to stand out in the meat uncooked.
Right. Because eventually they got to go in that little teeny piece of dough.
Right, right. So the smaller the better. This is one large onion, and I'm going to use about pound and a half of ground lamb and beef mixed.
A total altogether a pound and a half or a pound and a half each?
A pound and a half mixed. So one large onion.
But not a total of a pound and a half mixed?
Total of pound and a half
okay.
mixed meat. One large onion, I'm doing this now. I will put it in a frying pan, large frying pan. Just a minute, don't do anything.
Mm-hmm.
tablespoon of olive oil in here. Put the onions in the olive oil, pan with the olive oil.
So you didn't use all the onions?
Now you can use a little butter in there.
Mm-hmm.
Because your meat is gonna be extremely lean. You have, when you buy your meat, you have to tell the butcher to take all the fat off and grind it twice, so that you don't have any fat in your meat. Now I'm putting a little, I can't believe it's butter, about a tablespoon of that, and about a tablespoon of butter.
Regular
in
butter.
With the olive oil, yeah. Mix it with the olive oil in the pan. Because the meat is very lean.
But you didn't use all of the onions. Is that just because the pan's
there
not...
There was some onions before.
There's too much?
No, okay. There was some before in there.
Okay.
After this melts and you start stirring it, this much is a pound. This is pound, more than pound and a half.
Okay.
Because I'm going to mix it with the lamb. Lamb cooks faster, so I'm going to add it after I do this for a while.
Okay.
Lamb cooks much faster than beef. Now you stir it around until it's nice and soft. Not brown, but just nice and soft. Maybe I'll put the rest of the onions. I don't have to if there's more than each time.
I thought you might have been saving them for something.
No, I'm going to save it for the next batch. We're mm-hmm. going to make two batches of this and that, so we have enough meat.
Right.
Now you see how nice this looks already?
Mm-hmm.
It looks like almost.
Okay.
You don't want it to brown, right? This is the ground beef. Break it up. Break up the chunks, you know, by constantly breaking it up like this. And then it will... Now you have to lower your gas or heat.
Why is every homeless person in the world isn't here?
Who's this?
The smell out there is incredible.
Hi,
is
Auntie.
Is it coming out?
Oh, Mother.
Yeah.
I'm surprised the homeless aren't at your doorstep. Okay, how's it going?
Well, you should see that doll baby guy. She's smiling, my God.
So you think I came to see you?
She's smiling. Now I'm adding the lamb, ground lamb.
And this is exactly what you did with your mm-hmm. with the batch that's already done, right?
Yeah.
I'm still cooking it on high.
Okay.
Because there's a lot of meat in here.
Your burner is on high.
Yeah,
okay.
Still on high.
And you can't let it sit.
Yeah.
And pretty soon it'll go from that
it's gonna
to
be,
that.
It's going to be like that. Even the meat, if you want less manta, you can cut the recipe in half.
Okay. Yeah,
if there's water left in the pan, you want it to dry. You don't want a wet cooked meat. You want it dry because you have to be careful though. If you want it dry, it has to be dry. It shouldn't be overcooked. The water should evaporate. The water that's in the meat, you know, the juices should evaporate. That's as long as you cook it. After the water is evaporated, it means it's ready.
And you were saying something about when you season it?
You season it at the last. You season it after you turn the heat off and take the meat off the heat.
So the onions add a lot of moisture to it, a lot of water.
The onions do that. And the meat has moisture too.
Mm-hmm.
When the moisture is all evaporated, then it means it's okay to put your condiments in.
Do you keep your heat on high so it evaporates?
Your condiments in. We didn't say what condiments we put in.
No.
You have to put this. In the meat, I use cinnamon, salt and pepper, a little allspice. This is the seasoning for the meat. According to your to taste, you know, there's no amount. Ground cinnamon, ground pepper, black pepper or white pepper, and salt. That's all the seasoning. I don't use parsley. The book tells you parsley. Parsley changes the flavor of the whole thing. It doesn't call for parsley in my recipe. Now I'm going to put the salt and pepper to taste.
It's working like magic.
Allspice to taste. And cinnamon. Not too much cinnamon.
Yeah, if you put too much cinnamon, it's ruined, huh?
Yeah, not too much, just a dash. This is ready now.
Mmm, it smells delicious.
You know, are you taping?
Mm-hmm.
You know what we didn't say in the recipe was that you, of course, it's in your recipe, you put butter in the pans, you melted butter before you line up the mantas.
Oh, well, we're going to do that later.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay, we're going to do it later. This is ready now.
Okay.
I taste it for salt and for condiments. I taste it. Always taste it. Perfect. You're gonna make another batch, you have to empty this, right?
Right.
See, almost all the liquid is absorbed.
Yeah, most of it's gone. Oh, yes.
I'll just keep on filming.
Okay.
I have to ask this lady something when she has a moment.
I have a moment.
You have a moment?
I haven't made the fish yet.
No. I'm wondering.
Uh-oh. This is because...
Baby break.
This is because Melissa forgot the pencil. So we're being creative. We're being creative. Whatever works.
See, the finger keeps the air from going in.
Is that the theory?
Okay, you can have
She's so cute.
There you go. There you go.
She's as happy as
Look.
Silly thing. You silly goof.
And she's looking at you.
Hi, Phil.
You're all set, Grandma.
Wait until puberty.
I'm making a hole in the middle of it.
Wait, how much flour did you put in there?
6.5 to 7.
Okay.
For 3 large trays of manta. I'm measuring 1 tablespoon of salt to go in the dough. Light, one light tablespoon into the 1 cup water. Stirring it to melt. Pouring into that hole that I made in the flour.
Whip
the eggs slightly. 2 eggs.
2 eggs.
Sydney doesn't have something good to say to me.
The eggs go next into the water and flour. in the well. Next, the olive oil. One, two, three, 4 tablespoons of olive oil. To see this.
Okay. I'll be right there.
I'll bring it there. In the childbirth class.
You want to put it on the table and...
Put it here so you can see it. Can you see it?
Uh-huh. Perfect. No, I can't see it now.
Okay, I'm stirring
it. Yeah, right there. I can see it.
I'm stirring it.
Yep.
Now, the dough has to be firm, not sticky when I finish kneading it. It looks like I'm going to add more water because this is, I added a lot of more flour.
Let me take this off so you can work. I can walk over there a little bit.
I said the dough has to be firm, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not sticky. So I'm adding the water gradually.
And how much water was that? You had already said.
This was now about 2 cups of water because I'm making extra dough.
Mm-hmm.
Normally, for the regular measurements, it's 1.5 cups of water to 1.5 cups of water. But this is a lot of dough. Stirring it with a wooden spoon. It's always wise to add the water gradually. Julia Child does
right.
It on the wooden thing, and they put a lot of flour and then start kneading it. This doesn't need that kind of handling. It, as long as the dough is kneaded and holds together. Now I'm going to wet my hands with olive oil.
They're putting carbonate in today. They're closed today.
The reason you do this so that the dough doesn't stick to your fingers too much.
Oh. Did you want to ask or something?
No,
I need to
exchange
something.
Oh,
and
then
go later today.
Okay.
Okay.
My nail polish is going to come off.
Oh, no.
Put gloves on.
No, you can't.
You can't.
Surgical gloves?
Maybe.
Not for the dough.
Do you want me to do that part so you don't have to get your hands in it?
No. I have to get my hands in it.
Your nail polish is already dry, Grandma. It'll be fine.
Yeah, I think so.
Let me see how it is.
So now you're kneading the dough with your hands.
Mm-hmm. Getting it together. Looks like I got too much water in here. Michelle, can you open this? That's why I said you add the water gradually. I guess I put too much. In the pantry, there is a jar of canola oil on the left. Can you bring that, honey?
Mm-hmm.
You can throw this jar up.
Okay.
Can you see it
now? Mm-hmm. No, it looks great.
Well, it's really holding together now. It's a little too much water.
Mm-hmm.
It's always better to have more dough than less dough, because you can save the dough and make some meat bareks with it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Did your Abby thing, did you read it?
So what's the oil for now, Grandma?
So I can get the dough off of my hands, off
oh,
of my
okay.
fingers while I'm kneading it.
Right.
Well, this time her column is really nice.
Whose?
Of Carrion's.
Yeah, that was funny. Michelle, can you scratch right above where my finger is?
There's a scratching thing right over there.
It's right on, over that way, just a little bit more.
Grandma,
right.
Do you want some air in here? It's very nice outside.
We're going to open that window.
Thank you. Oh.
It's supposed to, when you turn it on, it just is supposed to date it.
What is it, January 7th, 1996?
Put,
and it's about 100 degrees.
Yeah, put all those things down.
Yep.
Grandma's kitchen is like 80 degrees.
Yeah.
January 7th, what's the date?
Beautiful. Actually, you know what I'll do?
Oh, God, what am I doing?
Look at what I'm going to do.
Let's in too much.
No, so. I'm going to take the photo.
Yeah, that's what it's like in January at Granny's house.
Yeah.
And we're here. Take a picture of us.
No, yeah. You don't want to see what we look
stand
like.
Stand next to the...
Grazi, look at your mom.
Stand next to the table.
Look at your mom. Look what you did to her. I'm going to get you for that. You'll pay.
Hi.
The rest of your life. No. Don't worry, I was like this before.
Oh, please.
No, you weren't.
No, my boobs were not as saggy, but...
Well.
Yeah, but...
That's what I'm really mad about, all right? I just want you to know the boob part. Can't do anything about that.
You can exercise.
Oh.
After I finish kneading, you're gonna have to feel the consistency so you know how firm the dough should be.
Okay.
Because when you roll it, you don't want a sticky dough. You're
going to
add flour when you roll it anyway, but roll it when you roll it out. But you can't have a sticky dough to begin with.
It looks fake.
Otherwise it won't roll.
It will roll, but you're going to need so much flour.
Right.
Melissa's tasting the boss from us. See, Harley, what kind of diet she's on?
Michelle.
It looks fake. Look.
That's tenderloin. Did you know that?
But look at the edges of it.
That's filet.
No,
that's
the edges.
That's the chimen. That's the chimen. The edges is the chimen, honey. Okay, I think now I want you to...
I got that on video.
I want you to feel the...
Okay, look, I have to take this ring off. Michelle, will you take it off? Do you want to feel the dough, Michelle? So you know?
Feels
like
good. Feels like dough.
Do it like... Well, like this. See?
Mm-hmm.
It shouldn't stick to your hand anymore. After you.
A little sticky.
It's still a little sticky.
Yeah. It's very moist.
Yeah.
What?
You
need too much water?
I did put too much water. But it's okay. I wanted more dough.
Michelle?
Yeah.
Before I forget about it, thanks.
Did you feel this?
Yes.
How did you feel it? Like this?
Yes, with my fist.
Good. Okay, now it does not stick to me anymore, to my hand anymore.
Okay.
I'm perfect.
She's perfect, Martha, right now.
You may put the canola oil away.
Oh, you made that cranberry thing again.
Mm-hmm.
Melissa's hunting out all the food in the... Let's see what there is. Yeah. I need to know what's going on. Oh, she's making beans.
I'm gonna make the bean salad.
Oh. See?
Okay, now. Now that the dough is ready, I'm gonna divide it into bowls.
Yeah, with a little olive oil vinegar and some.
Into bowls?
Parsley.
Onion. Tivoli has incredible white beans.
What
should
you
say? Oh. Bean salad.
Uh-oh. Oh, wait. I think that's... Yeah, we need to change tape, I think.
Already? Only 10 minutes. Well, yesterday...
Hang on, let me check it, Grandma.
Can you give me the flour? Put the top on it.
Okay.
Okay, now I'm kind of getting it together. I was here before I divide the dough. Okay. Now, in order to roll this out professionally, you use the small rolling pin first, the little round one first. Then, after it's about 12 inches all around, you start rolling with a long stick. Okay, this is going to be 1, 2.
How old is this?
This is
the neatest thing.
4. 5. Well, not really 5, but I'm going to make 5 because I'm going to let you roll out one.
Oh, good.
I'll roll out the big ones.
Okay.
Did you see Dad's car, Michelle?
Yeah, I drove it yesterday.
It's nice, huh?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, I'm flouring it now, so it doesn't stick to the
lighter is used.
Lots of flour.
I'm making balls.
They didn't clean that.
I'm making the balls.
It was clean, but it wasn't real clean. You could see.
Like this.
You get, you know, the value of your car is higher if you have never snowed in that.
Two.
Yeah. You could tell by looking at the lighter.
That's all right. I mean, as long as they didn't burn it anywhere.
You didn't put the baking powder in?
I forgot.
Uh-oh, so what are you supposed, how much are you supposed to put in the baking powder?
It's called for 2 teaspoons, but it's okay.
What does the baking powder do?
The AGBU cookbook doesn't call for baking powder.
Oh.
Anusha's recipe is the one that calls for baking powder.
So now we'll see what the difference is.
Yeah. It won't make any difference.
No?
But I used to use it in her recipe.
So you would put that in with the flour?
Is that her recipe, or are you doing this one?
We're doing
her recipe.
Her recipe. Oh. Okay, now we're going to cover this with a clean cloth so it doesn't dry up while we're working.
Okay.
Either a plastic or a towel. You might. Now we're going to do this more.
Can we let it rest for how long?
15-20 minutes.
Oh, Michelle.
Because it's tired.
By that time, you're going to oil you're going to butter your pans.
Wait, I'm not recording.
Real evenly.
What is it that you're putting in the pan?
Butter.
Melted butter.
Melted butter, half-half with, I can't believe it's butter. Half butter, half I can't believe it's butter. This is the way the tray should look when the butter is in there. Just about this much.
So it covers the bottom?
Yeah, so because the mantas are gonna cook in here, in the oven. They're going to be baked in here, okay? Some people brush it down, but this is easier and faster.
Great, Grandma.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now maybe you will need butter. We got 2 trays ready. Sometimes the butter tends to settle in the middle because it's hollow in the middle. You have to kind of, when you're lining it up, you have to kind of...
Before you do, yeah, start.
Dip the where there's butter and line it up like that.
Okay.
Okay, we're ready to start rolling.
Should we call Auntie Nan?
Is that what she said?
Yeah.
She wants to start, she wants to help pinch.
Oh. Well, we need...
Can you move the table back from the base, Melissa?
One has to fill.
Melissa.
One has to,
can you move that back from the base
pinch
a little bit?
Well, she wanted to be tall, though.
Okay.
Wait, say that again, Grandma.
The more the dough rests before you roll it, the easier it rolls. Understand what I'm saying?
So at least 15 minutes.
At least 20 minutes to half an hour it should rest the dough. You sprinkle the flour on there. You start with this rolling pin, the short rolling pin. You go round and round.
We gotta call Jeff Smith, the frugal gourmet, and have him do this on his show.
Yeah.
I'd like to see him do this by himself.
I'll be happy to demonstrate.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna write him a letter.
You go like this to spread the flour evenly.
And you have a flour on your nose.
I know, it's okay. Is it coming in the video?
Yep. No, you can't see it. I don't even have your face in the video.
No?
I have a close-up on the rolling pin.
Okay, now see how large it is now? It's easy to roll it now with a long rolling pin when it's large like that. Okay, here comes.
And the dough doesn't stick together, huh?
No, because there's flour underneath. You pull when you're rolling it. You pull out towards you. You pull down on the dough. You press on the stick and you pull the dough towards you. Now you go like this, spread the flour evenly. Mm. Then you start rolling from an opposite direction of the dough. You start in the middle, you push away from you, then you pull towards you.
So you're kind of stretching it a little.
I'm stretching it toward you. Now I'm going to start from this angle because it's thicker over there. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, again, you start from the middle, you go towards, then you stretch it out until it gets to the consistency, the thickness, about 1/4 inch.
No, not even
1/8 inch, you think?
Maybe.
Maybe an eighth.
Well, I'll let you test it and you'll see.
Well, once you cut it, does the dough start shrinking back or no?
Well, while I'm rolling it, it's even shrinking back.
Oh, okay.
Should we set the table before we leave today? Would that help you?
It would be a good idea. There's salad to be made.
Okay.
We'll roll it up. I'm going to make some meat burex too.
Oh, okay.
Because Michael loves meat burex. Michael loves meat burex.
I'll help you.
It's his favorite.
Yeah. Oh, I love meat burex too.
Do you?
Oh, yeah.
Grandma, there's nothing you make that we all don't
I
love.
I know.
Everybody has their favorite.
You use the same dough.
Allie likes the pilaki.
I love the pilaki.
That you...
For barrags?
Yeah, for those squares.
I wonder if you could stuff the barrags with pilaki.
Now, you want to fill this dough, see how thick it is, Michelle? I don't know about that.
This feels good, Grandma.
It's less than 1/8 of an inch.
Yeah, it's very thin.
Feel it like this.
It shouldn't
be too thin. It's just right now. And be sure you have lots of flour on it. Now, for an inexperienced manta maker, you take a knife,
Mickey.
Sharp knife.
I'm Melissa. And Michelle. And the rest of the world.
No, I'm a pro.
Don't count me in.
You're no pro.
Take a sharp knife and you cut in about 1 inch strips across. 1 inch strips evenly across.
Okay.
Then you come, after you've done the whole thing, you come and you start at the end another inch or 1 1/4. Those are your squares.
Okay.
After you've cut the whole thing, you cover it with plastic so the dough doesn't dry. If it dries, then you can't pinch it together. But since I know my way of doing was much faster.
Since you're the pro.
Yeah, I'm the pro.
When you advance and you've done it a couple times,
Now, I floured it a little bit so it doesn't stick together.
Don't attempt this on your own.
Right.
All right. Here we go. Here's what I'm doing.
You need a little warning thing to flash on the video screen.
I'm making the squares like this.
You're rolling it on top of each other, like a couple inches?
I'm rolling strips.
They're about 2 inches almost. It looks like 1 1/2 inches.
Okay. Let me close in on that, Grandma. Oh, that looks good. Okay.
Can you give me the towel, honey? Now I'm going to cut the strips into squares. Get it?
Got it.
But I don't cut too many at a time. Okay, line up over here. We're going to peel these out.
Oh, Grandma, why don't
you can hear.
And I'm filling. You'll do your cutting. I'm doing this.
Grandma?
Yeah.
Why don't you do a, show us how you do the boats?
Put the frame over here, who's going to do the filling?
Okay, go ahead.
I'm going to pinch it up so that this becomes a square.
Those are the end pieces, huh?
The end pieces, yeah.
Nancy, you want to make Monta?
Okay. Sit down, Melissa.
Wait, you're going to demonstrate.
Well, we're going to demonstrate it first. Oh, we're going to, this is what we do.
Well,
you take a small spoonful.
Here's the square. Take a small spoonful, press it down tightly in the center.
That's too, is that too much, Melissa?
No, it's not too much. Okay. Then you go like this. You take the outer edges, opposite edges, and you pinch it together like this. You mustn't show too much of the meat because when it's baking in the oven, it'll dry up too much. And then when you're placing this here, you go, you know, here.
You want
put
them up.
Another one. Too much. Okay, fine. Okay.
So you don't want too much meat in there, otherwise you won't.
Here we go.
Good. We're
see?
In the middle of a Monta video.
This is how it looks.
Wait.
This we're is how it should look.
That's a perfect Monta.
Okay.
That is perfect.
Got it.
Got it.
Okay. Line them up on the outer edges first. Okay. Stack it down, Melissa.
Okay. And then Nick, when we have the tray filled, you can come back to it.
Okay, let's see.
Melissa, you're playing with fire.
Kind of hold it, yeah. That looks beautiful. And
it's not full yet.
Hold it down a little more. Okay, good. Wow.
They're on a green background. There you go.
Nice.
Okay, that's enough.
Anyway, rolling.
Stick. We're rolling again.
I mean, you did that one tray. That
make
whole
a round circle. That one round made
wow
almost one tray.
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go.
We're joined now by Auntie Nan.
I want you to put the date.
The date's on there. Don't you worry.
Yeah.
Here's the small rolling pin.
Oh, Tracy RSVP. You'll be here.
Good.
Oh, mm-hmm. Said, do I, should I call Grass and I'll make another call. I'll tell them. I'm on my way over.
Okay, here
so
we go.
Was I be freezing and, or was she stuck inside? They had just baked two batches of brownie. I know what they're going to do all day. Cook.
Eat brownies.
Cook.
Yeah. Oh, it is brownie.
She went to this big mall, you know, our most biggest, best discount mall in Woodbury Common, which is a little upstate in New York. They went yesterday, she and her girlfriend went yesterday.
Uh-huh.
And I said, well, did you get anything? She said, why, the clothes are too expensive, even at that discount mall, she said, but
they are a lot of
we
time
came, we found a place called Le
okay
Gourmet.
This is about how many inches?
No, that's more than 12, I'd say 20.
From here, oh, round. Excuse me, I thought you meant the diameter.
Yeah.
The diameter is about 12.
Radius, you mean?
No, this is the diameter.
No, that's about 20.
It's not 20 inches.
Yes, it is.
It is not 20 inches, Nick.
Go get a measuring tape. How much you want to bet?
You may move.
I'll bet you $5,000.
Oh, yeah, I'm in the way of the stick.
All right, here we go.
Too late, Michelle.
Lots of flour to begin with.
I'll bet you maybe $100,000.
I'll tell you it ain't. Okay. You don't have $100,000.
Lots of flour.
So I know. She said it's a good thing we did because all week the snow is.
They have to stay inside.
She said, I know I won't
have. Uh oh.
Celebrating.
So this time we're not going to roll it as thin, or you just, parts of it are always going to be thinner than others?
It won't be as thin as the one before.
That's probably why it made so many.
Well, these are large rolls.
Stuck in New Jersey because they were doing some production work in studio.
It's a perfect dough. It rolls so good.
Oh, you didn't know that.
It's rolling so easy.
Yes, Rick Riles.
It's not pulling back.
Rick Riley.
Oh, good.
Riles.
He's almost a member of the family by default. Yeah.
By Danae.
God, it rolls so good. I could make baklava.
Oh,
no.
See, I want to roll the ends.
The
ends are thick.
Oh, I see. So you don't really roll the center, you roll the ends.
After a while, the ends are thick.
We're going to have all these videos, Mother, that I'm telling you.
This is a great idea.
I tell the AGBU, they would grab this up. I'm Nikki, I'm serious.
We have to edit it, though.
Yep, we will.
Well, you know, it's...
Did you hear that about that those two women in San Francisco, their mothers, and they're stay-at-home mothers, and they made a videotape of, it's 25 minutes long, and all it is are kids, little babies, faces, to music. That's all it is. And you know how many they're selling? 40,000 a week.
Oh, God.
A week. They put music in.
Just music and just different shots of babies' faces. And the kids love it, and the old people love it, and the old people's minds. Yes. It keeps
going. Okay, organize.
Okay, ready?
Organize.
Can you believe that?
Get the meat here in the tray.
We're ready, Grandma. We're just waiting for you.
Which tray do you want? That's that round?
That's your filling.
Now she usually likes one to pinch and one to fill.
Okay, I'll do it.
Spread it around.
Okay.
Now that bowl's to eat from, and that one you can eat and pinch and fill at the same time.
Oh, we're not doing our production line of one eats, one pinches, one fills.
Right.
Now I showed her how to do it when you do it alone.
Yeah.
You roll this thing
back.
That had a funny thing.
No, you don't
Grandma.
Do it this way.
What do you mean? You're only doing this because you're alone?
I think the underneath layer, did you get it all right?
It's
no,
almost,
it's not.
Oh, there
you go.
She got it. There she got it.
Had a crimp in it, huh?
Yeah.
You roll the thing like I rolled it.
Yeah.
Then you take a knife and you make this 1-inch
right,
strip.
You cut them.
Then you cut it this
That's
way.
That's right,
then
so you don't have a stack like this.
Then you cover it with plastic.
I remember
That's how
that.
This makes
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I remember that, so you don't have a stack.
Because when you're alone, Because
it dries
together.
It dries
if you're
fast,
alone, they
too.
Stick together.
Yeah, and it dries very fast, so. But you got so many people filling and pinching that you can, oh, I see what you mean. Yeah. Now you got to cut them.
Pinch.
Where do we want this tray? Right here?
The ends.
Yeah, I'll push
it. It's not important. Just put it here. You better
She likes, oh, we had that one's not finished.
No, this one's not
right.
full yet.
Okay, so I'll push him over. But someone, you're going to sit here right now.
Yeah, I'm going to we're going to leave the video on for a couple minutes.
Pinch it, okay?
And then they can see a team in action.
You want me to cut, Mother?
All right, start filling. Come on.
Okay, but I don't have any goop. Give me the goop. Thank you.
Who's going to pinch?
Nikki's pinching.
Nikki's pinching. Okay.
Don't put too much goop in, Auntie Nan.
Yeah, I know. I've done this before.
Yeah, Melissa,
you
just put too much in. Are you
in that one?
Yep.
Give me a minute. I'll get the hang of it.
It looks
grim
to start again.
That's why I'll be slow till I get my bearing.
No.
No good.
Don't leave me down for me.
Oh,
that's
you
not
made
mine.
A mistake.
Is that mine?
Yes.
Okay. I left it too open.
You're gonna get yelled at.
Well,
it dries up when it's
so
baked.
Long. That's right.
It dries up.
That's why
so
I need the video.
Like this.
That's why I need the video because I don't remember.
Now we get to listen to you get yelled at for a little while.
You gotta do it right.
Or
you're fired.
You're fired.
Well, you're not fired.
You're fired.
You're disqualified.
But then you're rehired really quickly again.
As long as you get the hang.
And you get back pay, too.
Oh, thank God. This is a fair opportunity, equal opportunity. Mm-hmm.
Like the government, they lay you off and then they pay you.
You're stretching them, Nikki. Oh, don't stretch them out.
See, that's another thing.
Keep them together.
That's
I got it.
They're growing all out of shape. I don't know.
We're not perfect. Well, because that's
well, the dough, I gotta tell you, Grandma, the squares are not the same squares when I get. They're different shaped squares all the time.
Yeah, they're more. These are a little more rectangles.
Some of them are rectangles. And
well,
some
if they're rectangle, okay. Do it the opposite way, then no, it'll be
it
square.
Perfect.
See, the dough is relaxed too much now.
Yeah, all right. I believe dough could relax. Wish I could.
Okay, we can turn this on now.
Well, they're going to look a little funny just for a little
well,
bit.
But we'll give those to the family.
Yep.
Oh, I got that on video.
400 and turn it to 375. And how long do you let it cook for?
Until they're nice and brown.
So like a half an hour about?
See, they're browning already. Mm-hmm. Oh, well, you have to watch it.
Like 15 minutes?
Half an hour or more.
No,
15 minutes. More than half an hour.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I'm giving
you. Okay, let's take them out.
Let's crack them out. I'll bring some napkins for these.
We have napkins out there.
It has to come to a boil, hard boil. And then you scoop it up with this. First you put the manta in the dish, in this bowl here, in the serving bowl. Then you scoop one or two scoops of the chicken broth in here. And then you serve it, take it to the table and you serve it.
And how do you serve it?
You just place it on the individuals in front of the individual who's going to have them.
With the madzun and the...
Well, no. They put their own madzun, their own yogurt, and their own garlic liquid, and their own sumac. Each individual dresses it up themselves the way they like it.
Okay. And how much... This is like 4 or 5 cans
this
of chicken
is,
broth.
Four large cans of
chicken broth.
For a... All right, now this is ready to be served.
Ooh.
Look well, it's at hot.
This.
It's hot.
Look at this beauty.
Don't you put that
gorgeous.
In the soup?
Gorgeous.
Put it in the soup, right? Is it soup or is it hot water?
No, chicken broth.
Soup.
Chicken broth,
okay. Chicken. Need any help?
That's it.
Oh, you're
so it's in the chicken broth, and you're putting the yogurt on.
Put a scoop of yogurt, a dollop.
Okay.
A
dollop.
How
and
much then, is in a dollop?
Oh, that looks like
and
about...
And that's garlic with water.
And this is garlic with water. And you sprinkle it on.
Fresh garlic.
Your
garlic. Yep, fresh garlic. Mm-hmm. And sumac. It's an herb.
And that's how you eat it. That's Monta.
Shoveling it in. When you get
okay,
your shovel,
go.
You get your shovel, you load it up.
Mm. See what you're missing, Gary?
Honey, she's dead asleep.
You can keep
it. Awaken the poor child, my God.
She's so look at her.
You're
so sweet.
Yeah, but she has to talk to get any money.
She will if he slaps her hard enough. She will.
Rick, you're only asking from trouble.
I know.
She's
on
Melissa.
For her first
stop it.
What is it for? Nodos?
For a
while. I'm not breaking her up.
Unisom. She's auditioning for Unisom.
It works.
Right. It works. We give it to infants.
Ask anybody.
She's so cute.
No, we play dope video.
She's at a joint.
Intervention. All right, this is the Monta party.
Oh my God.
I just give the baby a joint.
Grandma.
It was a good dinner, Grandma.
We're all very tired. Why do you
thank you very much.
I didn't get the Monta party on film, the official
tell
Monta party.
Tell them what the date is,
the
January 7th.
She did that already. She did that right in the
outside. All right.
The date, I keep telling them the date. date appears on the film every time you turn it on. It goes on.
The red light denotes that it's on.
Yeah.
Are you aware that there is no anything so fast?
Yeah, Rachel said that.
A fading out. Say goodbye.
Is it the rainbow room? $1,000